Hey, what's up? It's Comic95 the Savior, and for this video, I want to give you three reasons why Japan is not clean. So, reason number one, Japanese people do not wash their hands. So, you're probably thinking, what do you mean? Of course they wash their hands. Well, you're wrong, especially after going to the bathroom. This is not just a men-exclusive problem. As a woman going to the women's restroom, you don't normally see girls wash their hands after using the bathroom, and when they do, it's just a quick wash with just water, no soap, and they're out the door. I will also say in their defense, oftentimes bathrooms do not have soap, just water, so you have to bring or use your own, which I think is nasty in itself. But even with the water being provided, it's normally cold, and still, they do not wash their hands. They will go straight from taking a piss or poop and out the door. This is not a Japanese exclusive problem. I lived at Soccer House, and I noticed the Malaysian girls don't do this either. So maybe it's an all of Asia thing, but we're talking about Japan. Number two, Japanese people do not cover their mouth. Now, you've probably seen the infamous photos of Japanese people wearing masks. And you think, oh, they're so, you know, such big germaphobes. They don't want to get your germs, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, no. Oftentimes, Japanese people do wear masks if they are sick or to avoid getting sick. And it's also used for people to hide their ugliness, such as if they did not wear makeup for the day, or if it's an ugly guy, maybe he has big eyes, or he looks more attractive with the mask on versus off. I'm being serious. However, if a Japanese person needs to sneeze or anything like that, they will pull their mask off, sneeze on the ground, and if they are not wearing a mask, they will cough all out openly into the air. I'm not kidding you, no matter how small or tight of a space they are in. Now, in their defense, normally they try to turn away from you, but if not possible, they'll just face downward. And I'm sorry, it doesn't matter what direction you're facing. If you cough, I think it's common knowledge that you need to cover your mouth. Does it magically stop germs from spreading in the air? No, but it does kind of restrict them to you and your hand, and not so much gets out everywhere else. And on top of that, yes, it's nasty. You're going to use your hands to do other stuff, but you can simply wash your hands. You are not going to scrub that floor that you just rocketed your snot onto. And I do mean rocket snot, like you'll see snot just fly out of people's noses onto the platform at train stations. Happens all the time. And number three, speaking of noses, very, very common. People pick their nose all the time, especially if you're on the train. I hate this so much. I take the Hankyu Kyoto mainline train all the time, and I tell you, I swear, every single day, without any exceptions, any breaks in this rule, I always end up either sitting next to a nose picker or across from one. Age does not matter. And ironically, I see grown men doing this more than children. Now, children, fine, they get a pass. You can say, oh, they're kids, you know, whatever, but it's like you discipline them while they're young. But grown people, Japanese salarymen, they will have on a full-on business suit, be reading a book on how to be successful, their newspaper in the other hand, and somehow they magically have the third hand just swirling up in their nose. And then things get even nastier after they're done picking their nose. Yeah, you guessed it. They eat their boogers, and if they're not eating their boogers, they're rubbing them off on their pants. And it's like, oh, thanks for rubbing your nasty snot on your pant leg that's touching my leg, because we're on the train together, and it's crowded and packed. So packed that I can't even get up. Thank you. I really wanted your nasty boogers on my pant leg. And so I'm busy trying to give them the stink eye, and then while I'm busy, you know, thinking like, why are you doing that? Like, seriously? Like, why not just get a tissue? I will give you tissue. The guy across from me is doing the exact same thing. So yes, these are not stereotypes. It's factual. If you've ever lived in Japan, if you've been here for a long time, if you get to know Japanese people, they will never say that they're dirty. They say, oh, look at how clean toilets are and how clean streets are. Yeah, they are. Physically, they look clean. But how clean can your country really be when people don't practice the most basic of, you know, sanitary needs or means or cleanliness, which is just a simple washing of the hands? It is not done here commonly. I actually worked at two different restaurants here, and at both places, my coworkers would go straight from being outside handling trash and doing God knows what on their break, smoking anything else, to going straight in, back in the kitchen, making food. And it's like, you just took out the garbage and there's rats out there. and now you're making chicken and waffles. Okay, I know I don't want to eat here. So yeah. And then as far as dating people goes, I talked about this before, I think either in a video or in a comment to someone. I literally went on a date with my ex-boyfriend and he was sick, and he's literally picking his nose at the table at the restaurant. And there was a time where we were sitting together, I don't know if we were outside, I think on a park bench, and it was really crowded. There were lots of people like next to us. He literally turns towards me and coughs on my jacket. And I'm thinking, like, you idiot, like, how about you cough on your own shirt or go inside your own? Anyway, my point is, it's not just people that I don't know, it's people that I know personally. And if you watch your friends, your coworkers, etc., you will oftentimes see them go in and out the bathroom and wonder, did you wash your hands? You won't hear water running besides the little faucet thing, the little makeshift sink that toilets usually have. So yeah, it's pretty disgusted, pretty weirded out. But in general, people do not find the need to wash their hands. I've read and heard different things from people saying that overuse of soap is bad for you, blah, blah, blah. But underuse is just as bad. And I think that's the reason why people get sick here so often and so much. I've personally been victim of this. I've had strep throat 2 times since I've come to Japan. I've had a cold 3 times. And I had pneumonia just about a couple months ago, which I have not had since I was a newborn baby and almost died from it. So I think that has a lot to do with sanitariness or whatever here, and working with kids, which is what I do, is definitely put me at risk for getting sick a lot more often, because once again, hand sanitizer is practically non-existent, people don't use soap, bathrooms normally don't have them, people don't wash their hands, and then covering your mouth doesn't happen unless you have on a mask. They believe that the germs you get in your hands, you're not going to wash your hands, so you'll just touch everything, and that's debatable. But again, to me it's disrespectful where I come from to just cough out into the air, especially in a small, tight space, such as a packed Japanese train. And again, the nose picking, come on, boogers do not taste good. And as a grown person, doesn't it feel better to use a nice, soft, sexy piece of Kleenex to wipe your bedazzled nose than to shove your nasty finger up there? Just my opinion. So yeah, that's that. 3 reasons why Japan, look, I just put up a weird number. Yes. 3 reasons why Japan is not clean and is dirty. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you on my next video.